October 10th, 1960 is a date that very few people remember. Yet it was precisely that day 60 years ago that marked the beginning of the great epic of space exploration towards Mars. After flying over the moon in 1959 and photographing its hidden side with the probe Luna 3, the Soviet Union turned all its scientific and industrial power towards the Red Planet, considered the most similar to the Earth in view of future colonization. And it was the beginning of a real siege. The Soviets went on the attack first, and it was a massacre of probes. It will take as many as 10 years before we see the Soviet Union flag waving on Mars, but beaten on time by the United States. This first series of resounding failures began to instill the idea that Mars had something cursed, or even that the hypothetical inhabitants of the planet somehow managed to sabotage the launches and the successes of the missions. Then things started to improve slightly. As you can see from the small statistics we have prepared for you by counting the number of failed missions compared to those launched, with the relative percentage of failures. But why is it so difficult to land on Mars? And what can be true in the legend of the Curse of Mars? Before answering these questions, it will be useful to go over mission by mission all the attempts to land on the Red Planet, with the dates and reasons for any failures. Are you ready for this exciting space ride? October 10th, 1960, from Baikonur Cosmodrome, the USSR launches Mars 1. It is expected that the spacecraft will fly over the planet, but a failure in the second stage of the rocket vector prevents the mission to reach Earth orbit. One out of one, 100% failure. October 14th, 1960. The USSR tries again a few days later with the Mars 2 probe, but its fate is identical to that of its twin Mars 1. Rocket malfunction and destruction before reaching Earth orbit. 2 out of 2, 100% failure. October 14th, 1962. 2 years pass by and the Soviets try again with Sputnik 22. The mission is always the same, to fly over and photograph the surface of Mars. This time things go a little better. Before exploding together with the probe, the fourth stage of the rocket is able to reach Earth's orbit. 3 out of 3, 100% failure. November 1st, 1962. Another Mars 1 is launched for an overflight at 11,000 kilometers from the surface. This time everything seems to be working. The spacecraft is put on course towards Mars and is followed until March 21st, 1963, when at 106 million kilometers from Earth, the signal stops abruptly. 4 out of 4, 100% failure. November 4th, 1962. This time the Soviets change strategy and launch Sputnik 24 with the intent to have it land on the surface of Mars. It is in practice the first Martian lander. Too bad that everything ends up in pieces just before the orbit towards the Red Planet. 5 out of 5, 100% failure. November 5th, 1964. This time the US tries to launch Mariner 3. They also try to fly over Mars. But 1 hour after the launch, with the spacecraft now on course towards the planet, the technicians realize that the solar panels have not opened. The batteries run out and the signal is lost. 6 out of 6, 100% failure. November 28, 1964. Again the USA with Mariner 4, and this time the shot succeeds. On July 14, 1965, the spacecraft flies over Mars 9,800 kilometers away from the surface and sends to Earth the first photos of the Red Planet. 6 out of 7. 86% failure. November 30th, 1964. 2 days after the launch of Mariner 4, the Soviet Union tries again with the Zond 2, putting the two spacecraft in competition. The Mariner, as we have seen, made it, while the Zond lost contact in May due to a failure of the solar panels. 7 out of 8, 88% failure. February 25th, 1969. The race to the moon takes resources away from the interplanetary missions, and only 5 years later, the USA tries again with Mariner 6. And it is another success. The spacecraft passes on July 31st at 3,400 kilometers from the surface of Mars. 7 out of 9, 78% failure. March 27, 1969, the USSR wakes up and relaunches the game. They try to send a probe to orbit around Mars. It's called Mars 1969A, but a third stage malfunction makes the mission fail immediately. 8 out of 10, 80% failure. March 27, 1969, on the same day of the disaster of the Mars 2, the USA launches with success the Mariner 7, and on August 5, 1969, passes to 3,400 kilometers from the Martian surface. 8 out of 11, 73% failure. April 2, 1969, the USSR does not surrender and tries again to send an orbiter around Mars. It is the Mars 1969B that, however, explodes on the launch pad just 41 seconds after launch. 9 out of 12, 75% failure. May 9, 1971. Also, the USA dares to send an orbiter to Mars. Its name is Mariner 8. A flaw in the carrier rocket will drop it into the Atlantic Ocean after a few minutes of flight. 10 out of 13, 77% failure. May 10, 1971. The USSR launches the Cosmos 419, another orbiter. It is launched in competition with the American orbiter Mariner 8 and 9 to become the first satellite of Mars. Unfortunately, the race ends immediately and the probe is lost during the launch. 11 out of 14, 79% failure. May 19, 1971. Finally, the Soviets manage to reach Mars, and they do it with magic. We have to admit it, the Russians have always been more original than the Americans in their missions. That is to launch an orbiter, Mars 2, able then to bring down a lander on the surface. Unfortunately, the mission is only half successful because the lander crashes on the surface on November 27, 1971. 12 out of 16, 75% failure. May 28, 1971. The USSR launches the Mars 3 mission, once again formed by an orbiter and a lander, and both probes are successful. They arrive on Mars on December 2, 1971, and the first one enters in orbit, while the second one goes down quite gently on the surface, even if the communications will be lost after only 14 seconds from touchdown. The mission also proposes another novelty, the presence of a small rover that is tied to a leash should explore the terrain in a radius of 15 meters around the lander. Unfortunately, the sandstorm that rages in those very days damages the equipment of both the lander and the rover, and we will never know if it was able to move. 13 out of 19, 68% failure. May 30th, 1971, the USA launches Mariner 9, and on November 14th, 1971, finally succeed to put a probe in Martian orbit. 13 out of 20, 65% failure. July 21st, 1973. The Soviet Union launches the Mars 4 orbiter, but the failure of two computers on board makes it impossible to make course correction. It fails to reach the Mars orbit on February 10, 1974. 14 out of 21, 67% failure. July 25, 1973. The USSR launches the Mars 5 orbiter, which enters Martian orbit on February 12, 1974, but the contact is lost after only 5 days. 15 out of 22, 68% failure. August 5, 1973, the USSR launches Mars 6, a probe that will have to make a flyby with Mars and then release a lander. The spacecraft arrives on Mars on March 3, 1974, but the lander crashes on the surface. 16 out of 24, 67% failure. August 9, 1973. Same fate for the twin Mars 7, which arrives on Mars on March 3, 1974, releases the lander but missing the planet, ending up in orbit around the Sun. 17 out of 26, 65% failure. August 20, 1975. Complete success for the USA launching the Viking 1 mission, consisting of an orbiter and a lander. The probe enters into orbit on July 19, 1976, while the lander descends to the surface on July 20th. 17 out of 28, 61% failure. September 9, 1975. The twin probe Viking 2, with the same configuration, also departs. The orbiter arrives on August 7, 1976, while the lander goes down on September 3rd. two historical missions. 17 out of 30, 57% failure. July 7th, 1988. The USSR has extraordinary ideas, but rarely succeeds in realizing them. The mission Phobos 1, consisting of an orbiter and a lander to be lowered on Phobos, the largest moon of Mars. On September 2nd, however, a wrong command sent by a technician from Earth misaligns the solar panels, the batteries are discharged, and contacts are lost. 18 out of 31, 58% failure. July 2nd, 1988. The twin sister, Phobos 2, also leaves, with the same mission as the previous one. The probe arrives in Martian orbit on January 29, 1989, and manages to take some close images of Phobos. However, contact is lost when the lander is released. 19 out of 32, 59% failure. September 25, 1992. 21 years since the last failure, Mariner 8, the US fails with the Mars Observer mission. 3 days before the release into Martian orbit, on August 21, 1993, radio contact is lost. 20 out of 33, 61% failure. November 7, 1996. The US launches the Mars Global Surveyor Orbiter, which enters into Martian orbit on September 11, 1997. It will remain operational until 2006. 20 out of 34, 59% failure. November 16, 1996. The Soviet Union hasn't existed for years, and it's now Russia to launch its first probe to Mars, Mars 96. It's an ambitious mission which involves the arrival on Mars of an orbiter and surface stations with penetrators. None of this is realized because the rocket launcher explodes shortly after the launch. 21 out of 34, 62% failure. December 4, 1996. The USA launches the Mars Pathfinder mission, formed by the Pathfinder lander and the Sojourner rover. The Pathfinder lands on Mars on July 4, 1997. The rover remains operational until September 27. 21 out of 36, 58% failure. July 3, 1998, also Japan with the Nozomi spacecraft, destined to orbit Mars after a complicated gravitational assist tour. Its arrival was scheduled for October 11, 1999, but remained without fuel. It wanders around in search of other planetary assists. It has two more with Earth, to meet Mars in another point of its orbit. The mission was abandoned on December 14, 2003, after a five-year odyssey. 22 out of 37, 59% failure. December 11, 1998. The USA launches the Mars Climate Orbiter that arrives on Mars on September 23, 1999. However, the orbital insertion does not succeed because the probe is made to go down by mistake up to an altitude of 57 kilometers, where it is destroyed by friction. The cause of the disaster, incredibly, is due to the fact that different onboard software was processing data in different units of measurement. Maybe the legend of the curse of Mars grows stronger with this mission. 23 of 38, 61% failure. January 3, 1999. The USA try again with the Mars Polar Lander. The probe arrives on Mars on December 3, 1999, but contact is lost just before landing. 24 of 39, 32% failure. April 7, 2001. The USA launches the Mars Odyssey, which regularly enters into Martian orbit on October 24, 2001. A mission of great success. The orbiter is still operational. 24 of 40, 60% failure. June 2, 2003, first Martian mission for Europe. ESA launches the Mars Express, an orbiter that arrives on Mars on Christmas Day 2003. Also, this one is still fully operational today. On board the probe, there is also the English lander Beagle 2, whose traces will be lost just after the start of the descent. 25 out of 42, 60% failure. June 10, 2003. The USA launch the Mars Exploration Rover, a mission with the Spirit rover on board. Spirit is on the sands of Mars on January 4, 2004, and remains operational until 2010. 25 out of 43, 58% failure. July 8, 2003. The USA launched the twin mission Mars Exploration Rover B, with onboard the rover Opportunity. The landing on the surface is on January 25, 2004, and the rover remains operational until 2018. 25 of 44, 57% failure. August 12, 2005. The United States launches the Mars Reconnaissance Mission, which reaches Mars on January 10, 2006. The orbiter is still operational. 24 out of 45, 53% failure. August 4, 2007. The American mission Phoenix starts with a lander that gently descends on Mars on May 25, 2008. 24 of 46, 52% failure. November 8, 2011. After 15 years of silence, Russia gets back into the game and launches the ambitious Phobos Grunt mission. The probe should even descend on Phobos and then bring back to Earth soil samples. The Russians want to amaze the world, but unfortunately the mission fails due to the lack of ignition of the engine that should have put the probe on course to Mars. 25 out of 47, 53% failure. November 26, 2011. The U.S. launched the Mars Science Laboratory mission with the rover Curiosity on board. The rover lands on Mars on August 6, 2012 and is still operational. 25 out of 48, 52% failure. November 5, 2013. India is also in the race for Mars and launches the Mars Orbiter mission. The probe enters the Martian orbit on September 24, 2014 and is still operational. 25 out of 49, 51% failure. November 18, 2013. The U.S. launches the MAVEN orbiter that will reach the Martian orbit on September 21, 2014. Currently operational. 25 out of 50, 50% failure. March 14, 2016. Europe and Russia in collaboration launch the ExoMars Trace Gas Orbiter mission. On board also carries the Schiaparelli lander. The orbiter reaches the Martian orbit on October 19, 2016 and is still operational. The lander crashes on the surface. 26 out of 52, 50% failure. March 5, 2018. The U.S. launches the InSight mission, a lander that lands on the surface of Mars on November 26, 2018. Currently operational. 26 out of 53, 49% failure.